Hi everyone, I'm back with a money saving video today. So if you are not subscribed to my channel, click on the subscribe button if you want to learn more about saving money and getting organized. So today I am talking about saving money by making small changes. So what I mean by that it's something that I've been doing over a number of weeks, and that is changing my view on some of the things that I buy and using less. The idea being that these small changes can add up and end up saving you quite a bit of money. Now, if you start challenging yourself, what can I use less of? What can I use half of, for example, so that I am buying things less? So the first thing that I think I immediately was able to use less of was washing powder. Now, this is the one that I've just bought recently, and it was the Aldi brand washing powder. So this is supposed to be an extra large pack, 40 washes. Now, what I found interesting when I actually read the size of the packet, which I never normally do, is that it's super concentrated and that you can use less. And a few weeks ago, I gave my washing machine a really deep clean. So I cleaned all the seals, I cleaned it inside, I took the drawer out, and I had a real shock and found lots of congealed washing powder and fabric conditioner in the drawer. So I use powder rather than like a tablet or a gel. Now, I thought, oh my goodness, a lot of this washing powder is not even reaching the washing. So I cleaned it all out, and then I did a super hot wash with bleach, and I used white vinegar on a boiling hot wash, cleaned the washing machine. It was gleaming inside and out. And I decided, right, I'm going to use less, and I don't want any more buildup in my washing machine. So I started by following the instructions and using less anyway, but then I decided to half the amount of washing powder that I was using. And I found that it was washing just as well. There was no buildup, and it means that I'm actually buying less washing powder. I'm not having to buy it so often because I'm using less. So I thought, well, what else can I do and use less or use half of something? What can I do? So the next thing that I tried was fabric conditioner, and I got this bottle absolutely ages ago, and there's still some left. So it's a 3-litre bottle of Comfort. I love the smell of this stuff, and I got it really cheaply. And I have been using half again. I've been dosing, using the cap, but then halving what I actually put into my machine. And I found that it still leaves my clothes really soft, and my towels as well. Everything comes out really soft, and everything still smells really good. So I'm using half as much of that. I don't remember the last time I bought that, actually, fabric conditioner. It was ages ago. So there's another challenge. Can you save on washing powder? Can you save on fabric conditioner? The next thing is tumble dryer sheets. Now, I don't use these all the time, actually, and in fact, once the weather is better, all my washing goes outside and I don't use the tumble dryer in the summer months at all. But I do use these sometimes if I need to finish things off in the dryer, or there's something that I urgently need to wear, for example. But what I have found, if I am going to use these, then I will cut them in half and then put them in the dryer, and again, just as good. They leave a really lovely smell, and I'm using half as much. These are also really nice. Little tip is, if you take one out and put it in the door of your car, and it just makes your car smell nice, and you know, you get 40 in there and it lasts for a while in your car. The next thing that I decided, right, I'm going to use less of this, is my hair shampoo. So what I do is, you're supposed to only use a 10p size amount anyway, but I suppose I've got fairly sort of long hair. But what I've been trying to do is use less and wash, you know, my head, my roots. And then obviously, as the water's coming down, it's washing the rest of my hair without me putting on extra shampoo. So I've been trying to use half as much shampoo. And again, I'm getting away with it. It's absolutely fine, doing just as good a job. And you could do the same with hair conditioner. So I've been conditioning the ends of my hair. I haven't been conditioning my roots, which is actually better, because it doesn't get so greasy. So I'm actually conditioning half, probably about from halfway. So I'm using half as much by conditioning half of my hair. So again, I'm using less. The next thing that I do is that I buy quite cheap dishwasher tablets from Aldi. And I always rinse my plates before I put them in the dishwasher anyway, so nothing is going in that is really, really dirty. And what I've been doing is putting everything in the dishwasher and then cutting my tablets in half. And again, it's doing just as well. And I use an economy wash, so I'm always washing on cool water in the dishwasher. On an economy wash, I never use a normal or a heavy, you know, if I've got really dirty, like the lasagna dish or something, I'll wash that by hand anyway. So I'm using half a dishwasher tablet, and it works. Half is plenty. Brillo pads. This is a really good one. So I don't know if you buy these. They're like little, they're wire pads. My nan used to use these when I was a little girl. And they've got soap in them. And they're really good. I use them for cleaning. Sometimes I've got really something really mucky on my hard floor, I'll use those. And I've got a utility sink in my garage, which is a really old stainless steel sink that gets battered. So I use a Brillo pad on that. But I cut these in half because actually, once you start wetting them, they go rusty anyway. So cut them in half and then use them. The next thing is metal scourers, and I buy these. Again, it's for really dirty, like lasagna dishes and things like that. I wouldn't use it on my non-stick pans. But I also use it. This is brilliant for cleaning glass. So if you've got water droplets on your shower door, for example, these are fantastic and they last for ages. But what I do, because they're all scrunched up, obviously, like this, is I cut these in half, and then I have one by my sink downstairs and one by my sink upstairs so that I can do the shower. Fantastic things for cleaning glass, try it. But you can get away with using half. The next thing is cloths. So I do buy some cloths for cleaning the bathroom, ones that are fairly disposable. Again, I cut those in half. And the last thing that I've got is these. I buy these from Poundland. So I've got the flash ones this time, but sometimes I get like their own brand. I've already cut this one, but I think it was probably about that long, but I cut them into at least like 4 or 5 pieces, so that then, because otherwise if you use it, you normally need to throw it away fairly quickly and it does sort of disintegrate. So I cut them up, so they'll last for ages if I cut them into 4 or cut them into 5. So there are some tips of things that you can use less of or use half of. Challenge yourself. What can you use less of so that you can actually buy less? And give me some ideas. So if you could put anything in the comments below, things that I can use less of or any ideas that you've got, that would be brilliant. I'd love to try it. And I will do an updated video then about all of the new things I find that I can use less of and save money. So that being said, please subscribe to my channel, stick around. I'd love for you to be one of my subscribers, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.